What's up, Crypto Nation? I'm your host, the Data Lord. Welcome to Centralized TV Reports. Let's read the news. Got a good story for you today. Solana news can help soar. What's next for the high speed layer one? This article brought to you by CryptoBriefing.com. Key takeaways: Solana has made a number of big announcements at Breakpoint this weekend. Breakpoint is their, the Solana ecosystem's meetup. It's like a conference. They do a lot of announcements there annually. But Sol failed to react. Solana has faced many challenges over crypto winter, including ongoing outages and a decline in DeFi activity. So while Solana has issues to overcome and competition to face, it remains one of crypto's strongest and most promising ecosystems. Solana is one of several layer one networks to have suffered in the enduring crypto winter, but sunny skies could return, Chris Williams writes. Solana makes a splash at Breakpoint. It was a big weekend for Solana as the layer one network hosted the 2022 edition of its Breakpoint conference. As for Sol, not so much. The thousands of Solana fans that flocked to Lisbon for the layer one blockchain's flagship event were treated to several big announcements throughout the conference. Arguably, the biggest one came Saturday when Google Cloud revealed it was running a Solana validator and it would start indexing Solana data via its BigQuery products in early 2023. Not bad. Google Cloud will also make Solana available via its blockchain node engine to help users run their own nodes in the cloud. Per CoinGecko data, Solana immediately rallied double digits past $38 as the announcement broke, but momentum didn't last. It's since cooled by 5.5%, trading at around $34 today. All right. In a different approach to their other blockchains, such as Ethereum, the various engineers working in the Solana ecosystem have focused on building products for the mass market. An example of such a product is its Saga phone, which aims to be the world's first Web3 ready smartphone. Innovative. Solana announced at Breakpoint that it would ship the product to developers as soon as next month. Ooh, got a Web3 phone. We'll report on that when that pops up. USDC issuer Circle has also appeared at Breakpoint, announcing that it could make its Eurocoin offering available on Solana in the first half of 2023. Eurocoin is already live on Ethereum. Circle also revealed its forthcoming cross-chain protocol would support Solana. Arguably, GameFi's most anticipated title, Star Atlas developers shared an early demo for the game at Breakpoint. Solana's high-speed capabilities, it claims to process 65,000 transactions per second, could make it a prime candidate for Web3 gaming space. But as there are no leading titles available to play today, it's unclear how much progress the teams have made and whether Solana will become a hub for the niche. Games typically take years to develop, so it could be some time until Solana's GameFi ecosystem picks up. So that's really interesting. I do think we're going to see a lot of experiments, with Web3, blockchain, gaming start to really pop up. We see, already some companies like Epic are playing around with NFTs integrated in with their games. But I'm curious to see, beyond NFTs, what integrations cryptocurrency and Web3 might have in video games. So we'll be deep diving that here on DCTV on a regular basis about how Web3 is developing and what it even means for a game to be Web3, right? What does it mean? People actually have different opinions on that, so let's keep reading. The state of Solana DeFi. Like much of the crypto space, Solana has had a rocky year, not least in its DeFi ecosystem. And for anyone who doesn't know, DeFi stands for decentralized finance. It's basically using smart contracts to do lending so people can basically arbitrage and have more money than they would normally, you know, to keep their trades moving. So Solana topped $10 billion in total value locked as Solana near $260 in November 2021, around the time of inauguration edition of Breakpoint. I said that wrong. Around the time of the inaugural edition of Breakpoint. The total value locked in Solana DeFi. So you can see, you know, we had quite a bit here end of 2021, and it's really gone down. And I'm interested to see why that is. I'm sure there could be a lot of conspiracies and speculation, so interesting topic. However, Solana DeFi has taken a beating this year thanks to crashing market prices, liquidity taking flight to other networks, and brutal token unlocks schedules diluting the value of some of the ecosystem stars of 2021. According to DeFi Llama data, today the total value locked on Solana is around $968 million, just shy of a billion, which is slightly less than Avalanche's $1.31 billion and a fraction of Ethereum's $32.29 billion. If the numbers don't drastically change in the future, Solana may find that it thrives in other areas. However, it's also worth noting that the total value locked has remained more stable in Solana terms this year, down around 54% from its June 2022 peak to roughly 31.3 million Solana. Notably, Solana now trails the Ethereum Layer 2 network, Arbitrum, in total value locked terms, and only slightly leads ahead of Optimism. If Layer 2 continues to grow at this current pace, Solana could find that Solana could find that it's not only in competition with other Layer 1 networks for liquidity. Both the Mango Markets and Solend exploits were possible due to low liquidity levels on their platform, which made it easier for whales to manipulate their markets to take out outsized loans. While Solana protocols are coming up with solutions to such problems, the network's DeFi ecosystem could continue to run into issues as long as its liquidity is low. While Solana DeFi is down, by far the biggest criticism leveled at the network is over its repeated outages. Solana has suffered from two long downtimes on multiple occasions over the past 2 years, most notably in September 2021, when it went down for 18 hours. Solana has been hit by four major outages in 2022, with the most recent downtime last month occurring due to a misconfigured node. Though outages have been a persistent problem for the networks, Solana Labs CEO Anatoly Yakovenko has said that a forthcoming upgrade will prevent such incidents in the future. If Solana can overcome the problem as he promises, the network should be in a much better position by the next crypto market boom. Interesting topic here. So DeFi has been a big experiment, right? Like what happens if we allow, you know, lending? So some people are putting their money in to get interest because they don't really want to trade it. Other people are sophisticated traders and are taking on the risk of the markets fluctuating, and they want to borrow more money so they can, you know, make bigger arbitrage. So all of that happens without banks involved. It's all done via smart contract. So it's really an interesting topic, but it is a big experiment, and there are a lot of coins like Avalanche and Solana specifically that are doing, and also Cosmos, that are doing a lot of this like DeFi lending. So it's interesting to see what issues pop up as we actually run the experiment, right? As the chaos that humans bring into a system pop up, we may find some things that need to be hardened in security. We find some things that need to be tweaked in our systems in order to, you know, prevent these exploits and problems from happening. But I think Solana is interesting, having such a high transaction per second that even if DeFi doesn't end up being its niche, it's okay. It still has it as a capability, right? And as time goes on, I think every blockchain, I shouldn't say that, many blockchains will have their own specialties and reasons why you might use one blockchain over another. So I think interconnectivity of blockchains is pretty important. Let's keep reading the news. Leveling, high speeds, and low costs. So while Solana DeFi may be in a slump, the same can't be said for the network's NFT ecosystem. With the second biggest NFT ecosystem behind Ethereum, Solana has built a fast-growing community of so-called JPEG enthusiasts. This year, collections like D-Gods and Utes have taken the NFT scene by storm, trading at thousands of dollars on the secondary markets despite adverse market conditions. Solana has also attracted many big names from the digital art world. At Breakpoint, Metaplex announced that it would launch immersive 3D NFTs from Beeple on Solana, taking a notable branch out of from Ethereum. PeoplePleaser, another leading artist in the NFT space, has also previously launched Solana NFTs, where much of the mainstream attention over non-fungible digital collectibles has been on Ethereum. NFT natives have seen that activity is growing on its strongest competitor network. The next NFT bull cycle could look different to the last one, now that Solana's NFT community and infrastructure have gained so much pace throughout the bear market. Solana also seems to be aware of its standing in the GameFi world due to its high-speed, low-cost capabilities. Breakpoint featured an entire day dedicated to the Buzzy sector, which was where Star Atlas and other teams showed off their latest progress to a packed room of would-be Web3 gamers. What's the future for Solana? While the network has challenges to overcome, it's abundantly clear that many positive developments are coming from the network. The various announcements made at Breakpoint prove the talented companies, artists, and projects are taking a keen interest in the Solana network despite difficulties it has faced. It's also worth pointing out that Solana and Sol aren't the only victims of crypto winter. While Sol is down around 86.9% from its peak after outperforming in 2021, many other Layer 1 networks have suffered similar losses. DeFi has also taken a beating across the board, with Ethereum coming out strongest. Historically, Ethereum's competitors, sometimes dubbed Ethereum killers, have seen activity wane and their tokens die off in bear markets, but none of them has had as many positive developments as Solana has done over recent months. Interesting. Perhaps the greatest hurdle ahead for the network lies in its competition. The new Layer 1 networks Aptos and Sui, both developed by former Meta employees, aka Facebook, aka Faceballs, have been compared to Solana owing to their promise of high speed. And both projects have raised nine-figure war chests this year. Aptos, which claims it can process 10,000 transactions per second through its Move programming language, launched with a token airdrop last month and anticipated for its growth is high. Sui is also believed to be preparing its own airdrop. Capital is merciless in crypto. If these projects successfully capture the space's attention, they could end up outpacing Solana on the next market rally. As with other leaders of what's become known as the alternative Layer 1 space, Solana will also soon have competition in the form of Layer 2 networks. Arbitrum and Optimism's rapid growth this year has proven that the liquidity will flood to Layer 2 if Ethereum succeeds, and many other Layer 2 projects are yet to be launched in earnest. Still, Solana has one of crypto's most active and fastest growing ecosystems, with several promising developments on the horizon. Despite its issues, it's clear that the network isn't going anywhere anytime soon. As for Sol, while the utility token may not be moving today, that's not uncommon for crypto bear markets. However positive the news cycle looks. Once sentiment flips to bullish, though, there's good reason to believe that Sol could see the benefit. Disclosure: at the time of writing, the author of this piece owned ETH and several of the cryptocurrencies. Ooh. You have your money where your mouth is. Interesting. The information on or accessed through this website is obtained from independent sources we believe to be accurate and reliable, but Decentral Media Inc. makes no representation or warranty to the timeless completeness or accuracy of the information on or access to the website. This Central Media Inc. is not an investment. Blah, blah, blah. Sounds good. TLDR. That's who they is. Interesting stuff, yeah? Looks like Solana currently is doing okay with DeFi, but isn't the leader. That's okay. They're doing great with NFTs, and they're likely to be quite a competitor to Ethereum, although with this next bull market impending, Ethereum is now proof of stake, so they won't have the big, you know, fees they had straining the proof of work network system. And you know, when it comes to gaming, it looks like Solana probably is the place to go if it really can support the amount of, you know, transactions per second they claim. And you know, beyond that, looks like in general, Solana has some promising outcomes, at least having more integrations with Google and nodes and development tools. So I suppose the question I have for you is, what do you think? What do you think Solana is going to do through the bear market? And have you ever invested in or traded NFTs on Solana? Because I have. And I can tell you that it's fast and it's a good experience. And I think that's probably its most promising application currently is going to be NFT in games. So if only I knew somebody who was setting up Solana infrastructure right now. I'm your host, The Data Lord. Thanks for joining us with DCTV Reports. We'll talk to you next time.